Hello, friends and guests. We'd like to welcome everyone to Scarborough's Chapel for a live celebration ceremony this morning. At this time, we'd like to invite the Chavez family to please step forward, and we invite everyone to please rise and center your attention to the front doors. Thank you.
To know God's responsibility and duties above all else. From the slums to Beverly Hills, it did not matter. As long as he could bring even parts of the world, you stood shoulder to shoulder and he loved you and your commitment to your calling. It has been an honor to hear how you interacted with him and how and what they learned from him. You are now tasked with keeping his words alive. Tasked to continue spreading the gospel from street corners around the world and every place in between. Born January 24th, 1961 in Dallas. Children Ashley and Carson, Jenna, Anthony, Andrew, and Paul. Reuben had come, cousins, countless friends, family, we thank you for your prayers. It is your prayers and God's mercy that became an amazing.
Amen.
Thank you for being here. He loved each and every one of you. Continue.
Our Father in heaven, we're so grateful. Certainly, Brother Reuben would receive the glory and honor and praise. And we thank you for this time. We ask your Spirit would be with us now, lead us and guide us. After a while, they came back. So, And those three of you who will stand up and speak, although no one will ever fill his shoes. A physical death. Those of us who loved Reuben, the only consolation of Reuben, Jesus and the Father. You know, by the way, the Bible says Jesus went and preached to those in prison, didn't he? Amen. When the dead will hear the voice of the Son of God, also to have life in him. Marvel at this. And will come forth those who did the good deeds to a resurrection or unwelcome events in our lives. In our Psalm 116, verse 15. I don't want to offend anybody. In fact, I'm going to stop, y'all. I'm not here to preach it. Now, God lived forever. Whoever lived until Jesus came wrote these words. Never intended that man should die in the world. The fellowship of God depends on God. But death is not the end of man for God. A devoted and loved husband, father, turned to God from whence it came. Mind is written in light of God's promise, 9:27. It is a point. Frailty. Out of reflection, we should ask ourselves the eternal question. You should ask yourself that question on a regular basis. Yourself and his Son, Jesus, gave the judgment. He must deny himself, loses his life for my sake, will find it. For what will it profit a man with his angel? Only with him we must die. Jesus commands us to love the Lord your God with all your heart. God only commands that he gave his only begotten Son. God became a man, lived on earth 33 years, partook of the same flesh and blood that we those who Savior, we have victory over sin and the whole world. And if Christ has not been raised, witnesses of God, the dead are not raised. We are saved by a living Savior. They lived in a town called Bethany, which was whenever he came to Jerusalem, remember, with a fatal illness and died in 2 days. Jesus was out in 27. Martha, of God, God will give you the last day. Jesus said to her, believes in me will live even if he dies. Do you believe this? She said, Jesus Christ is Christ to the believers concerning the promise of victory over death and the Bible, and that he was buried, and then to all the apostles, and last of all, Paul says, proven by many witnesses. Paul continues, I tell you, and the dead, but then this perishable will have put on death. Is swallow the sting, forgive you, fill you, and talk with you, counsel with you, field, Savonarola, and all the great opens at all those big events. As he knelt at the feet of his crucified Lord, Bible!
Request it would be that every
Someday these ashes will jump to life. We're glad. Now to him who is able to keep you from stumbling and to make you stand in the presence of his glory, blameless with great joy, before all time and now and forever. Amen. Now you all are invited to the reception at the Double Tree by Hilton at 7320 Greenleaf Avenue, Whittier. We're gonna go to the back to, okay. We'll turn it over to the director here.
Thank you.
Thank you, Pastor.
Step outside here into the garden area. We started at 1 o'clock.
The symbolism of the white doves. The family has asked me to bring our white doves here.